Hey everyone, it's finally here. It's finally here, Final Fantasy VI Pixel Remaster. Just came out yesterday, in fact. So we're gonna take a look at it. We're gonna see how it holds up to previous versions and just really show it off. I don't have any other plan for this video. It's gonna be very similar to how I've covered the previous Pixel Remasters, which on the whole, really like, would love them to come to consoles eventually. Please, Square, for the love of God, just do it. It's worth it for the music alone. I mean, the redone music, the rearranged tracks have been incredible, and Final Fantasy VI in particular has an amazing soundtrack, so I'm super excited. And thank you for those of you who are checking this video out, to whether you're curious about the game or, you know, you're a long-time subscriber. Thank you. Really appreciate it. And we're gonna load a little file I've started. As you can see, I'm only like 6 minutes in. We've basically just gone through the opening cutscene, which I can't stress enough how good Terra's theme sounds in this version, chaps. I'm not going to show it off in this video, but trust me, it gave me all the goosebumps. And yeah, let's see how the Pixel Remaster of Final Fantasy VI holds up. Now, it is probably going to be incredibly similar to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. However, I do know that in certain sequences in this game, they've done a little bit more than they have done for previous remasters, in that I think that the opera scene in particular has had some tweaking. I think possibly it looks like some 2D HD going on. Like the Octopath kind of visuals, which is really cool. But obviously we're not going to get to that point in this video. But I just thought I'd mention that. It looks like for that scene in particular, they've gone above and beyond. But here we have our first fight, and as you can see, the UI is just the same as the other remasters. There isn't too much I can say about it other than, yeah, the font still isn't my favorite, but it's really not that big of a deal. And the spell effects look really nice. The battle screens, seeing it, you know, upscaled like this is gorgeous. I really personally quite like the sprite work, even if it does seem a little bit simpler and less detailed than the originals, or at least the versions that I'm familiar with. I've played the SNES version and the PS1 version. I'm not too familiar with the Game Boy Advance version, so I can't really compare it to that, but yeah, I mean, the game itself is phenomenal. It's really just what this version does different, and that is mostly the music, which, from what I've heard so far, I mean, the battle theme is cool and all. It was never my favorite Final Fantasy battle theme, to be honest. Neither this or the boss theme were ever something, you know, I just think are quite weak compared to the rest of the game's music. But it's still really good to hear them rearranged and all that. There we go. Wedge and Biggs getting the level. They're totally going to get a chance to really make the most of that, aren't they? Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, as you can see, I think the game looks gorgeous. I really do. We're going to get as far as I can. I'd love to show off the world map at least. But hopefully this video will help you decide whether or not you want to, you know, take the plunge and buy this game for possibly God knows how many times you will have bought it, because I mean, it's been released on Steam prior to this, but that was like the mobile port, which I was not a big fan of, I'll be honest. Visually, I think it looked, you know, pretty terrible. So this version already has a massive improvement for me, because it is very similar to how it looked on the SNES. And that's one thing that I really like about the Pixel Remaster so far, is they're all very consistent visually now. Which you may prefer, or you may not, for, you know, especially the earlier games, you might not like it. I think I do still prefer the PSP versions of 4 and especially 1 and 2. But honestly, I mean, I think it would be very nitpicky, at least for me, to really criticize the visuals of this too much. I mean, it looks fantastic. Really nice edition of the mini-map, of course. In fact, I'll open up the menu as well. There's the map. Really, really sweet. And the UI, honestly, I keep saying the word honestly a lot, don't I? I'm not lying to you, I swear. I really like it. I think it's pretty darn good. I don't know what they could really do to improve it. You got really nice, you know, options here, cursor memory, all that standard stuff. You've got that weird, you know, filter that you can turn on if you want your nostalgic, old school visual. And yeah, there's not much else to it, really. I'll put Terra in the back. There we go. So, yeah, Final Fantasy VI does take a while to get going, doesn't it? You don't really unlock magic or espers until quite a chunk into the game, so we're not going to be able to see any of that in this video, unfortunately. But please do let me know if you've played this so far. I mean, it did come out yesterday, so I imagine quite a few of you probably will have done. Do you like it so far? How are you finding the difficulty? Because I know a few of the previous Pixel remasters have definitely felt like the difficulty's been changed somewhat. Possibly been made easier in some, harder in others. It's very much dependent on the game. But yeah, Final Fantasy VI. I mean, I would love to play through this version in its entirety eventually. I just don't really have the time right now. And it wasn't too long ago that I did play through this game. It was, well, actually about 3 years ago now. I have a Let's Play if you want to check it out. But yeah, there's not too much I can probably say. I think this video might be, well, it's just to show off the game, isn't it? So I don't know. Let's go for a Bio Blast. Always like that one. Yeah, the spell effects look really nice. I'm looking forward to hearing more of the music, actually. Obviously, in this area, there isn't really any music. You just hear the wind blowing through Narsh, and we found the cave. According to our source, some miners unearthed a frozen esper in a new shaft they were digging. This must be it. Here we go. Okay, now we get a bit more music. Ooh, it's very atmospheric. Got a save point? No, I'm good. I know what save points are. Yeah, at this point we can't really go anywhere because the Magitek's huge and it won't really fit. We got some wheel rat and a bandit. And yeah, enemy sprite work looks very similar, again, to the original. Which I do like a lot. Final Fantasy VI definitely had some of the weirder enemy designs as well. I'll handle this. Stand back. So, this won't be a very long video, but like I said, I might actually stream this, you know, at some point. I reckon I probably will, but right now, we've got a boss fight. And the first instance of the boss music as well. Which I said, I'm not the biggest fan of it, but it's a pretty badass track. I just find it quite repetitive. My throat is giving out on me, which is good. Thanks, throat. This thing's they must have trained it to guard the mines. What are you talking about? You know what this is? Ever heard of a lightning whelk? I have not. It's a monster that absorbs lightning. Ooh, I like this version of this track. Oh, yeah. Right, so whatever you do, don't attack the shell. Yeah, it's always the first boss in a Final Fantasy that has this kind of mechanic, where you either don't attack it in a certain state, or you just don't attack a part of it. We'll hit it with a fire beam. We just gotta watch out and make sure when it does retreat into its shell that we don't attack it. Let's go for a Magitek missile. Ooh, that damage. Slime, thank you. That's gross. I can't wait to listen to the rest of this game's soundtrack. Oh, crap. You would hide in your shell at that particular moment, wouldn't you? Mega Vault. Yep, that's gonna sting. Bye, Biggs. Bye. Let's do some healing. I don't think we can revive at this point, can we? No, we don't, we don't have any means of doing that. Ooh, yeah, I can already tell. I dig this version a lot. I really do. Right. Let's finish him off. Is it just me or is the ATB filling really slowly? I might have to up the battle speed a little bit. And there it goes. Poor Biggs. I'm gonna miss out on all the XP. Da-na-na-da-na. Right, so this opening bit is nearly over. I would very much like to get to the world map. Because Final Fantasy VI was such a visual departure from 4 and 5. 4 and 5 look exactly the same, pretty much. But 6, you know, they really pushed the SNES to the limit. Ooh. Frozen Esper. This thing's giving me the creeps. Something's not right. Alright, Biggs and Wedge, get ready to get sent to another dimension or something. Spoilers. There they go. Bye! It's so funny that, you know, Biggs and Wedge appear in a lot of Final Fantasies. They usually have a slightly bigger role than this. They get taken out so early. Yeah, that's not good. Yeah, the music is good. This video is gonna get so copywritten. It's ridiculous. Where am I? Oh my, I know, we just removed the crown. My head hurts. Oh, this music. Oh yeah, oh my god, it's so good. Are we gonna get the individual character intros like we did in the original? Should be right about now, I think. Here we go. Yeah. I always liked this. A mysterious young woman, born with a gift of magic and enslaved by the Gastalian Empire. And her name is Terra, which we will keep. Which I will... How do I do this with the gamepad? I guess I'll just have to press enter. Use this name? Yes. Terra, in my mind, is the main character of this game, although it really is more of an ensemble piece. Way more than, you know, previous games, or even games hence. Must be made of tougher stuff than most. Uh-oh. Evil woofters. I always thought that these guards were, like, mummies. Like Egyptian mummies. It looks like they're wearing like bandages wrapped around their heads. We're here for the Magitek armor, pilot. Well, you're not gonna have her. Open this door right now. Hand over the girl. She's an agent of the Empire. Not willingly, mate. Not willingly. Empire? Magitek armor? No time to explain. You need to get out of here. These fools aren't going to listen to reason. So we're very much on our own now, and I just got an achievement. Mystifying Woman. Another reason why I need this on console. I need my trophies. Come on, Gabe. Come on, Square. Please. Port this to console. For the love of God. Right. And we can sprint. Yay. Up there. Uh-oh. Also, my dog wants to come in the room. Typical. Typical. I'll be right back. Alright, sorry about that. Blooming animals, hey? Growling at me door. Alright, so we're gonna get through the mines. Just kind of run through here. Some more weir rats. Nice block. Yeah, I might up the battle speed a little bit. It's a little bit sluggish for my liking, although I don't like it too fast because it can get overwhelming, especially with the old ATB system, enemies being able to attack you if you dilly dally shilly shally. So I'm not going to worry about picking up any of the chests in here, I don't think, not right now anyway. Not the to be honest, I should do because. This probably isn't going to be like a full playthrough or anything, so. But the reason I wouldn't pick up those chests is I think they get better items if you open them later in the game, unless I'm thinking of a different place. My Final Fantasy VI knowledge is a little bit rusty. But yeah, I honestly, I keep on saying that word. Oh, you keep on using that word. I do know what it means, but I use it too much. But yeah, very, very impressed with this. Very impressed. Even like the damage font a lot. That seems quite true to the original. Oh no. Oh no. Ready for convenient cave-in. Yay. Uh-oh. Ooh, this is very jazzy, very jazzy theme, isn't it? Oh, and there he is. Blummin' Kefka. Everyone's favorite villain. Even though I think he is super overrated. Yeah, you'll- oh, I want to hear his laugh, actually. We're not going to get to hear that yet, are we? Yeah, I would like to hear Kefka's laugh, but that's probably not going to be for a while. Don't get me wrong. I do like Kefka. I think there are better villains in the series. Ooh, I can see one of my favorite characters. In fact, probably my favorite character in the whole game. Long live Emperor Gestahl! So yeah, Terra is currently out for the count. And look who we have here. It's everyone's favorite thief. I mean, treasure hunter. I always love that. A treasure hunter and trail-worn traveler searching the world over for relics of the past. I always liked Locke because he had a bandana. Kind of like Solid Snake from Metal Gear Solid. Which is also, like, one of my favorite games of all time. I prefer the term treasure hunting. Semantic nonsense. There's a huge difference. The sprites are so expressive. Is there anything you need me to do? Yeah, I met the girl. I'm kind of just going to skip through this dialogue, chaps. Again, if you've never played Final Fantasy VI, I think this is a great version to do that with. And yeah, obviously it's not going to have all the content that was added in like the Game Boy Advance version. Which is a shame. That is another I'd say downside of these versions, but overall, I think the positives far outweigh the negatives. And that's my honest opinion, since I seem to love that word so much today. That's a lot of wolfmen. There's a whole bunch of them. Koopo! Oh god, yeah, this bit. I must admit, the Moogles and the defending Terra is a bit of a pain. And there's a few sequences like this in the game that I'm always like, you know what? I wish I could kind of just skip this. But the Moogles, dude. Would you like an explanation? No. So I'm just going to make a beeline for the commander, because that's pretty much the best way of doing this, I think. So we got a bunch of Moogles with us. We can also steal with Locke. Because he is a thief, contrary to what he keeps telling us. Couldn't steal. Great. Problem is, the enemies do a lot of damage. This part can be quite difficult. For such an, you know, early part of the game, I have struggled with this in the past. Because you really don't have many means of healing at this point. And look, I mean, that's a lot of damage. It's a lot of damage. Luckily, these Moogles are pretty strong. And I could swap parties, but you know what? If we just get to the commander and kill him, then we'll be good. No, stop using Snowstorm. Does look really nice though, but stop it. That Spear Moogle does a lot of damage to freaking Moglin. Moglin's an animal. Right. Commander, die. Although, Moogles are also going to die. Oh no, Locke's dead. Crap. Okay, this might not go very well, chaps. Let's pray that the Moogles can do this. Oh no. Oh no. We might be in trouble. I may have been too foolhardy. Yeah, heal yourself. You're the only. Oh, only heals by 50. Yeah, I think we might actually get a game over here. Oh my god! I mean, we're not gonna get a game over because we got another party, but still. That commander, very annoying. Luckily, we can just get straight. Oh. Do you mind, sir? I might actually just wait for him to get out of the way. Which way is he gonna go, though? Is he gonna go right or left? Come on. Come on. Obviously, I think it's game over if they do get to Terra, so... That sucks, but we should have plenty of time. Go left. Go left. Go left. Go left. Oh, I don't want to fight him. Nah, we should be good. Oh, but the Mog's leading this party. Yeah, look at Mog. 240 HP. Get in, my son. Ooh, I think we just learned to dance. She might be able to show off. Oh, okay. For a second, I thought we had a back attack. Dance Twilight Requiem. Cave-in, it missed. Great. It missed. Yeah, you're in trouble now, God Leader. Oh, nice! Swallow him up. I can't talk. Swallowed him up. Oh my god, I can't talk! Swallowed him up completely. There we go. Got it out eventually. High potion. Nice one, Moogles. Nice one, Mog. I love Mog. Can we please have another Final Fantasy with a Moogle that you can actually play as? That'd be great. Right, out of the caves we go. Just want to get to the world map. You back with us now? Yeah, she's awake. You saved me? Yeah, the Moogles actually did most of the work. You lost your memory? Yep, another character with amnesia. Final Fantasy sure does love those. Yeah, but Locke's a good guy. This version of this music is so jazzy. Alright, let's get the heck out of Nosh. Although we could possibly visit the training room. I'm not gonna bother with that. World map, you ready? Although, oh, it keeps this music, doesn't it? Okay, so immediately I'm noticing that the color scheme is slightly different here. Not massively different, but yeah. Does look like the color palette is a little bit... I don't know whether it's washed out or... But honestly, looks fine. Looks fine to me. And... Oh crap, I forgot Locke was... Oh, I forgot Locke was dead. 69 HP. Nice one, Terra. But I think we're just about done with this video, chaps. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that it was worth your time. Go check out the Final Fantasy VI Pixel Remaster. From what I've played so far, which admittedly is very little, it looks great. It looks really cool. I also like that they've kept the original portraits as well. That's a nice touch. But yes, this was my coverage of the Final Fantasy VI Pixel Remaster. I really, really hope you did find this video somewhat useful. And if you did, please like it as well. That would really, really help. Gosh, I hate self-promotion. Thanks for checking this out, guys. Take care. Stay safe, please. For the love of God, stay safe. And I will see you in whatever video you decide to watch next. Bye-bye for now.